Hey friends, you know that Dapr is a portable event-driven serverless runtime that makes it easier for you to build resilient, stateless, and stateful microservice applications that run on the cloud and the edge. Even better, you can use it with your favorite languages and your favorite frameworks. Aman and Yaron are here to introduce this new distributed application runtime today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, it's Azure Friday. I'm Scott Hanselman. I'm here with Aman and Yaron, and we're going to talk about Dapr, D-A-P-R. What does that stand for?
Distributed Application Runtime.
Okay. There's a lot of distributed applications. There's a lot of runtimes. There's a lot of things out there that make my distributed application building better. What does this add to me?
So Dapr runs alongside your application, either as a sidecar process or a container. And it gives you these capabilities like state management, pub/sub, service discovery, things that developers are looking for when they're building their distributed applications. And because it communicates over HTTP or gRPC, it's basically friendly to any language out there.
Okay, so HTTP, gRPC, it's agnostic.
Yes.
Any framework, any language. But there are other frameworks that help me do these kind of distributed things like Steeltoe and Spring Boot, and you know, and I could list out a half dozen different things that that are prescriptions. How opinionated is this, and does it mean that I have to stop using something I'm already using?
Definitely not. Dapr is really friendly to all these frameworks because it's really lightweight and it runs next to your application. It can just run with your Spring Boot application. You can take as many features as you want from Dapr. Mm-hmm. It doesn't need to be all or nothing. So if you just want pub/sub, if you just want state management, you only take these, and these can enrich the frameworks that you're using, or you know, your app if you're not using any other.
That's cool, because if you think about things from a microservices perspective, it's all about the single responsibility principle.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If I make a shopping cart service or I make a product service, I go, oh, you know, I really need a state repository. I should write that. Well, but I'm a store. It's not my job. It's not my responsibility. Mm-hmm. Then you're saying I could go to Dapr and I can kind of, like a cafeteria or a buffet, pick the ones that I want, and you'll handle it for me.
Yeah, and you can use state management, pub/sub, binding, or actor capabilities, whatever you want from it.
And using one of them doesn't mean I have to use them all.
Yeah, correct. True.
Very cool. Yep. Okay. I see that you have two laptops and two people here.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So that must mean you have an amazing demo to show.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
All right.
We hope.
Let's go.
Okay, so I'll be starting.
So we're starting on the Mac.
Yeah. So here I have a Node.js application. Let's say I'm a Node.js developer, and I want to get an event from, let's say, Event Hubs, and then push that event to storage.
Mm-hmm.
So if I just started my application without Dapr, I would need to look up the Event Hubs SDK, pull it into my code, test it, see how to use it, and then the same for whatever storage I want to use. But with Dapr, I basically only need to have an HTTP endpoint listening on something called Event Hubs to receive event from Event Hubs. And when I push the data that I receive to storage, the only thing I need to do is just to return this JSON response saying, hey, the thing from the Event Hubs request to that storage entity here. And these two entities are defined here. So this is our Event Hubs component.
Mm-hmm.
This is a Dapr file that basically ties this component into a code. So notice the name Event Hubs here and the name Event Hubs on the application post. I have my connection string here. I'm not going to expand it because it contains the secret. But when we're running on Kubernetes, for example, you can hook in Kubernetes secrets and even Azure Key Vault. So we have secret stores as pluggable components as well.
So in this case, you're assuming that you're running this container within the context of Kubernetes, but I assume that any container orchestration system, it's agnostic in that respect
yes,
as well.
Yes, yes. And this is the blob storage, so it's named storage. So if we go back into my JavaScript application, I'm getting events from Event Hubs and then pushing it off to storage. Now, this can also be AWS S3, it can be Google Cloud Storage. So I can basically put bindings in place and then replace them. And then I'll just start sending off data to other systems without actually changing my application or even needing to restart it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it's platform agnostic, language neutral, vendor neutral.
Wow.
I can use
so let's see a short demo. So I'm just going to do Dapr run here. And this is the Dapr CLI. So I'm going to run this thing locally. And basically, I'm telling Dapr that my application is listening on port 3000. And then I'm just going to launch the app here. So this gives me a really nice experience because both the application logs and Dapr logs are showing on the same terminal. So I can see my application logs and the Dapr logs. And the only thing that's left to do now is just to send a message to event hubs. So I have this TypeScript thing here, just going to send off a message. Mm-hmm. Message sent, and we'll go back here. We can see that we got the message, and here we're pushing it off to Azure Blob Storage. So if I go to the Azure portal, let me just refresh that.
So the Node application is one of the microservices is talking over to Dapr, which is in the other virtual desktop. And it's pushed that out there. And it doesn't know that it's talking to Azure Storage. It's just talking to the Dapr.
Yeah, it's talking to a very generic thing, storage.
And then, generic thing. The API was quite simple.
Yes, and then operators can come in and switch these bindings with the storage or queue or message bus component of their choice. Mm-hmm. So we can see the file here. So that's how we trigger bind an application. And again, because this is all done via HTTP, you can use any language. And this is also achievable via gRPC, like we said.
Very cool.
Yeah.
All right, so that was on the Mac. Why do we have a PC here?
So on the PC, I'm going to show you the ASP.NET Core integration. Like we said, it can be integrated with any platform. So we're going to show the ASP.NET Core integration here.
All right, let's do it.
So this is showing a very simple, not so secure kind of a banking application in which you have a controller. You can get account balance using the get route. And then you can deposit money. And then you can withdraw money. There's a withdraw method there.
So pretty straightforward, typical REST API using ASP.NET Core.
Yes, right. And then since Dapr provides PubSub capabilities also, you can subscribe to a particular topic, and in response to event published to that topic, this controller method would be executed or triggered for you automatically. And then it also shows the state capabilities of Dapr. You are interacting with your state using the state client, which is injected for you in the DI controller.
That's a really nice thing, just from a an idiomatic C-sharp perspective, that even though that you've made a generic thing, the way that you've integrated it here with ASP.NET with the state client as a parameter attribute is really nice. You're just saying, from services, if you were, and I respect you for that, because if you were being more lazy, there would have been a line of code where you'd go and have to write a get. And by doing it like that, as an ASP.NET programmer, that feels very natural. So it sounds like this Dapr product feels natural to everyone on their language, because it's very lightweight.
Yeah, we wanted to be framework friendly and do the most natural thing for that particular framework.
That's really cool.
Yeah. And so this is showing the state management capabilities. You are getting the state. And like Yaron mentioned, a state can be stored in any underlying state provider configured with Dapr. It could be Redis. It could be Cosmos DB. Or it could be AWS storage. It can be stored anywhere.
Cool.
So I'm going to just run this using the Dapr CLI. So since our Dapr CLI is also cross-platform, we want to meet developers where they are, whether it's Mac, Windows, or Linux. It works everywhere, so you can develop your applications wherever you want to do that.
Cool.
So this is running the ASP.NET Core application, and I'm going to make some client calls to it. Since these are just curl calls, that means you can run this ASP.NET Core application, and your other microservice could be in any other language making calls to it. So this is first call making call to get the state. Basically, it got the balance information from there. Now I'm going to send another publish command to it. Basically, it's publishing a message to withdraw topic, which is going to invoke our controller, and which is going to execute that method and going to withdraw the money from it. So I make that call. It will. It has executed. And if I query it again, you will see that the balance has been decremented from there.
It's so interesting to see really clever orchestrations like this working so smoothly, because somehow, you know, hello world, in the past, this kind of stuff would take huge amounts of effort, huge amounts of work, huge amounts of computer science, and you've basically compartmentalized all of those services such that we're standing on the shoulders of giants, and I mean like computer science giants.
Definitely.
Yep.
Cool. So how do I get this, and how do I start using this?
So it's available as an open source framework on GitHub, and then you can download it from there using our releases from there.
GitHub.com/Dapr/Dapr
Okay, so D-A-P-R,
D-A-P-R
is the organization, and the project is D-A-P-R. And is this 1.0? Is it in active development? What's the plans?
It's currently experimental, like most of open source projects are when they get released. We really want to take community feedback and hear what other people have to say, you know, before we announce a 1.0 release. So we're currently at a 0.1 release.
So we have added some of the building blocks which we thought they were important, like PubSub, bindings, triggering, actors, state management. If community wants to add more building blocks, it's really open, and we can add more components to it.
That's cool. Well, I'm glad that you brought it here first. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. I am learning all about Dapr here on Azure Friday, and you are too. Make sure that you go to github.com/DAPR/DAPR. Get involved, check it out, provide them with feedback, because this is your opportunity to help, you know, shape the roadmap, the future roadmap, and get them to 1.0 today on Azure Friday.